Ikum bokum, ikum bokum. Hey, how you doing? Oh my god. It came out of nowhere. I was gonna say hi and then the game scared me. Oh shoot. And darn it. Cause this game's like rated PG. If games had movie ratings, that's what this game would have. But welcome to Full Play Banjo-Tooie, Part 1. The music's very loud in my ear. I'm going to turn it down. All right. So this is the amazing sequel to the smash hit Banjo-Kazooie for Nintendo 64. It says 2009. That's not true. Xbox Live 2009. OG, like 2000. I think this game came out in 2000. It might have been like 98 and 2000 or some crap like that. I don't know. I'm going to play offline here because I'm playing as the Gormster. If you watch the State of Decay Full Play, you can see there. Because why not start with an empty achievement list? Gormley can get achievements in other games too, as long as they're recorded. If it's not recorded, he's not allowed to do it. So I'm just going to fire off, okay? And this baby takes place right after the first one. Tensions are high. Well, they weren't very high. Gruntilda got her ass whooped on. If you're not familiar with the story, maybe Google, Banjo-Kazooie Let's Play, and maybe you'll find something. See, look, it's telling you the story here. Shh, it's a cutscene, even though it's words. Shh, quiet, don't talk over it. Personally, I love this game. I've talked about it for quite a while. I'm actually pretty excited to finally slap this up, considering I've had Banjo as my Minecraft avatar since whenever the hell episode we did it, like 10 or some shit, I don't know. And I'm sure a lot of people don't know what the hell it is, and they should. And that's terrible. So I'm glad that it's on the Xbox Live Arcade. So this is where the main villain of the first game left off. You beat her ass, you knocked her off a cliff, and then a boulder fell on top of her, and she got her ass stuck. And this dude's like, I'm trying to get you out, but you're too fat, and you're stuck. And that's why you're here. So yeah. But I love this game. It picks up right where the first one left off. Actually, in the game, meaning it's a game where you kind of run around and get new abilities and such as you play. And this one, you actually start with every single ability you got in the first game, which is cool. Because most games, like Metroid U or Castlevania U, where they're like, oh, you know, all that shit that you got last time, it's gone for no reason. Start over again because they don't want to give you all that shit. Banjo-Tooie says no. I'm gonna give you all of it. It's all yours. This opening is gonna take forever, by the way. So, you know. I mean, you can read it. They're playing cards. Knock at the door. That's Bottles. He taught y'all the moves in the first game. And there's Mumbo Jumbo. He's like, ikum bokum, ikum bokum. And then he turned you into little animals and shit. So you could be different characters in different levels. I always looked at this game as the way more fun version of Super Mario 64. Which is fun. But you don't get any abilities or anything throughout the whole game. You just run around and collect shit forever. And in this one, you kind of run around and collect shit, but it's not as long. And I like the worlds much more. They're way more colorful and shit. Especially Banjo-Tooie. Because this one's, it's probably like three times the size of the first game. So welcome to part one at 800,000. I'm sure you're happy that I'm doing another brand new game. You know what? I don't care. It's Sunday. What else were you doing? Nothing. Going to church? I doubt it. There's a big fucking drill coming through there. Hang on, I'm gonna take a sip of my water. Ah, yeah. Fun fact. When I went to pick this game up from Toys R Us, didn't reserve it, but I got a VHS tape from Nintendo sent to my house, and they're like, hey, this game's coming out, it's crazy, check it out. And I thought it was crazy, so I checked it out and I wanted to buy it. Didn't reserve it, went to the store, I got the little ticket, and then I brought it to the game counter and hit the button and waited 40 minutes for the guy to come. And he's like, all right, I'm going to hook you up. I'm going to give you a little Mumbo Jumbo plushie doll with it. Because everyone who reserved it gets one. And fucking nobody reserved it. So I was like, oh, yeah. Sucks for them. I was turning around to make sure the microphone was still going. It's going strong, baby. Here we go. Something's happening now. I could have skipped this, but then nobody would know what's going on, okay? These bitches is ugly as fuck. And they all wear tight leather for some reason. Cause it's sexy, that's why. Oh my god. There we go. It's like a Quentin Tarantino movie. They're just like walking out of the door for 15 minutes. So they showed up a little late. It took them 2 years to get here. Mysterious Sisters, okay, weren't mentioned in the first game. Totally added it in, okay? It was a total edit, and they were like, she's got sisters now. But, yeah, people are still waiting for the third one. I mean, so these were the only two games that came out, and then Banjo-Kazooie Nuts and Bolts came out way later, like 2008 or 2009 for the Xbox 360, but it's a completely different game. It's not really a platformer at all. It's a fun game, but it's not really a sequel to these two at all. So, you know, if you want to make another one, that'd be great. I'd play it. Then I could play a new game, you know? It'd be new. And, yeah, and I would play it, and, that's about it. Come on, just fucking, I was waiting for this cutscene to end. I love the music in this game. And the stupid Nintendo sound effects. She's still putting up a fight, she's still struggling under there. Part one, the opening cutscene. Alright, they're gonna get to the bottom of it. I didn't even notice she was fucking holding a cat. Holding, strangling. I'm assuming that's a cat? Or it was part of her arm. Oh yeah, and these assholes only talk in rhymes. Just the witches, for whatever reason. Apparently that is their way. Okay, just gonna... Oh my god! Couldn't you have just dug around it? If that's all you had to do? Like, you could have just got a shovel and dug around the boulder and just been like, hey, just walk out. But he didn't want to do it. Oh, she's skin and bone. Well, just bones, not skin. It might be a better look for her, though. Bum, bum, bum. So the whole plot of the first game was she kidnapped Tootie, Banjo's little sister, and she wanted to use this, like, beauty sucker machine where she'd throw her ass in and then Grunty would get in the other side and she was gonna suck the beauty out of her, make her all hot and shit. So now she's like, dude, I'm not only am I not hot, I'm extra grossies. My eyeball falls out. It like the guy in the Pirates movies. And the guy, and what else was he in? He was in the British version of The Office. I don't know his name. Gavin knows his name. He talks about it a lot. It's like he's obsessed with the guy or something. But that's what she just did. Although this probably came out before Pirates. So actually, Pirates took it from her. Son of a bitch. I'd look into that. See what came out first, this game or Pirates of the Caribbean. And I never understood that because everyone always says Caribbean. Like, where are you going? I'm going to the Caribbeans. But when they're talking about the movie, they say the Caribbean. And I don't get that. I say it too, but the movie made me do it. That's just the name of the movie. This bitch is berserk. Okay, we're almost about to play the game here. But there is a rousing game of cards going on. And Banjo's got a shitload of money. So Banjo, he's like nice, lovable guy, hero, you know, character. Kazooie the bird, she's a bitch. She's just like a bitch. Which is pretty funny though, because she's always got sassy things to say. Like, wah, wah, wah. Like, no you didn't. And they're like, Kazooie, I get you, I swear to God. I wish they kind of added a Kazooie thing in some way to Minecraft, to the skins. Like, because you just have Banjo, and you can't have Kazooie popping out of the pack. There's no just Kazooie. Why Kazooie get no love? She's in the title, Banjo's a dude, Kazooie's a girl. She's half the game. What the hell is that about? Rare, or Nintendo, or whoever? Well, I'm calling bullshit. It's a kangaroo court. Bottles, no! Oh my god, I'm gonna get in the fucking drill. Oof. Oh. So I played this game when it first came out on Nintendo 64 like a million times, like the first one. I've actually never beaten it on the Xbox Live Arcade. I got like halfway through it and then just never got around to finishing it. But there's a level way later in the game, I think it's one of the last few levels, where when you're flying overhead, there's like a dick in the ground. It's kind of like a prehistoric level, so there's like a swamp, and then there's rocks and shit for you to like jump on, and it looks like a penis and balls. But in this version, they took it out, which is total bullshit. Just leave it in there. It was in the Nintendo 64 version. It's fine. So I'll point it out when I get there and it isn't there. Maybe I'll actually do some editing and I'll do a side-by-side of the original. so you can see the dick and balls in all its glory. Because it's like history at this point. You know when you're like researching and like medical stuff and whatnot, and it's like, oh, breasts, but it's okay because it's a medical show and it's about the surgery, so you're allowed to show it. It's like that. Okay, I'm trying to teach you the history of the game, so you might see a penis, you know, an island in the shape of a penis. But it's not a real penis, it can't get you. That, not until 3D. Banjo, that's what we call Banjo-Tooie 3D. And then the dicks will come out of the TV and they'll get you. Oh, so, Bottles got fucking blasted, because he was in there. Oh, because, yeah, Kazooie and Bottles, they don't like each other, so he was sad. Hey, there he is. He's fine. He's fine. Kind of a dark beginning to the game. It gets worse. I was hoping I could do the fucking trailer. Like the whole introduction and then the first level in part one, but good lord, that's gonna take a while. Oh yeah, there you go, he's dead. Especially because the biggest difference in this game compared to the first one is there's tons of shit to collect in every world. Again, similar to Super Mario, where this game has puzzle pieces or jigsaw pieces, you call them jiggies, instead of stars. And then there's notes to collect instead of coins, but it's more or less the same thing. But in this game, there's a lot of the levels, you can't get everything until you get an ability from a level later on. So I know even the first world, you can only get 9 out of the 10 jiggies, and you can't get the 10th one until you get like an ability from world 4 or some shit. So the game's way bigger, it's way more fucking convoluted. It's more fun in my opinion, but it'll be a pain in the ass to get everything, because, you know, I have to get everything. So let's, you know, strap on in. Oh, am I gonna get the move? Here we go! Here we go! I'm moving, mama! Woohoo! Woo! Let me check the time on the recording. Hang on. Okay, so that's 14 minutes. You know, I probably fucked around for like 2 minutes. We're probably like 11 or 12 minutes into the video? 11 or 12 minutes in, Michael's moving the controller! Okay. You know, I think maybe it's a boring start to a full play, and I shouldn't do it because then people won't watch it. But fuck you. History. Okay, history is at stake here. So this is the exact same starting area as the first game. It's really cool if you played the first game because you'll be like, oh my god, I've been there. Except it's all fucked up and shit. It wasn't such a goddamn mess 2 years ago. But it's the kind of the training area where they teach you how to use all the basic shit. And then this time around, they probably teach you how to use all the shit you used in the last game, but I'm not going to do that because I know how to do it. For example, holding the left trigger and then the right trigger gives you the Talon Trot. Makes an incredibly annoying noise from Kazooie. You get used to it real quick, though, but you move, like, twice as fast, and you can run up hills and shit. So, I'll pretty much play the whole damn game like this. Don't worry about it. If you're confused, I'll fill you in as we go. You're going to be like, oh my god, what is that? And I'll tell you what it is. I think there's something behind the waterfall here. Check it out. Except I'm not, probably not going to be able to make that. Oh god! I especially won't make the jump if I don't jump. There's a little, like, torpedo door. See, it's already like Castlevania or fucking Metroid where there's shit that we can't open now. And we'll have to come back to it later. It's just, there's nothing we can do. Alright, there's nothing we can do. I'm probably going to have to do, like, pickups in between episodes, where after I finish an episode and upload it and everyone freaks out about all the shit I missed, I'll probably have to go collect that shit next time. But, again, we're going to be playing this game for the next 3 or 4 years, so don't worry about it. Get used to it. We're dug in. This is Klungo. I was going to say, I couldn't think of anything to rhyme. I was going to say he's a Mungo, but that's too stupid to say, and I said it anyway, so I feel like I should have just kept my mouth shut. But, boss fight, right off the bat, mini boss, whatever. I'm gonna hold down the A button. You can still read it, but... I swear to God, if anybody complains about me talking over cutscenes, I'm gonna strangle them to death through the internet. Oh, I'm sorry you couldn't hear... Or... Oh, yeah. Do you think he takes that before he bangs? Oh, shit! Woo! Okay, alright. What's the strategy here? Let's see. I haven't played this game in maybe like 3 years, so I have a... Oh my god, I have a good grasp on it. I'll be fine with the controls, but I'll probably forget what to do a bunch. What a bitch. You wasted it! See those little jumping honeycombs in the back right? That's health. So if you're missing health, you want to grab that shit. Suck it up. Get it. Bears. They like honey. You know, pretty much fuck you, Kazooie. We don't really care. You're a secondary character. What, oh! What the hell am I doing here? What am I doing? I think I gotta do something with the fucking potions. I just can't remember what. Like, hit him in the face with them. Oh, let me get some eggs. You can shoot eggs. Kazooie can shoot eggs out of her mouth and out of her asshole. Oh, God! Ah! Oh! Oh, did he get boo-boos again? How do you... What do I do here? What am I doing? Yeah, there you go. Yeah, you don't like that, do you, bitch? Yeah, you do. Yeah, you do! Yeah! Oh, he's chucking more. He's chucking more. That means I did good. Let me shoot your ass some more. Oh, what's happening? He's got shrinking problems. This is a problem that, you know, it's pretty common for men. You're not alone, fellas out there. Whoa! At least I assume I'm doing something. Oh, yeah, look at that. I could tell I did something because I got the black bars at the top and the bottom. So I knew a cinematic was coming. Look at the 2000 cinematic technology. And also look at our very first achievement in Banjo-Tooie! 4.1! Knocked out Klungo. Look at that. I beat his ass in first try. 20 gamer score on the board. You asked for it, sucka. I'm pretty sure the achievements are easy as shit in this game. In fact, after he leaves, let's take a look. Looking at achievements, that's what we'll do with Michael and friends. Wait, there's no friends, it's just Michael. But there could be friends in the future, you know? If I make some, you know, from in between now and when I record stuff. So let's check the achievements in this game. I already got one. There's only 12. Blah, blah, blah. Probably need, okay, I don't, treasure hunt. I think that's like get one of every kind of collectible, which is easy as shit. That's, kill a bunch of people with different shit. Beat a boss. This one, actually, like, the stop and swap shit, that's, that, you have to, like, collect shit in the first game on Xbox Live Arcade, and there's a way to carry it over, so I might do that at some point. But it looks like all these achievements are level-based, honestly. Like, this one's another mini-game. There's a mini-game. And, yeah, that's pretty much it. It's a pretty shitty list, actually. If you cared about achievements, the list sucks. I don't want to dissect it. Would have taken forever. I do like that they had all nice little cute little descriptions for each one. Fuck me. That was me hitting the back button to check my mini-map. Not Assassin's Creed 4. This is Banjo-Tooie. I'm actually about to finish that game for the second time. Beat it once on the 360, and now I'm like maybe 2 hours from beating it on the Xbox One. I'd have perfection in both if it weren't for multiplayer achievements. Fucking fun game. Highly recommend it. If you like the Assassin's Creed series, Assassin's Creed 4, fun as shit. I love the ship battles. I like going pew-pew. The story's kind of, it ends kind of abruptly, which I was kind of like, what? I kind of got, like, bust, like Halo 2. Like, da-na-na-na-na-na-na, and then it was over. But, fun game. Obviously, I played it twice, because I'm stupid. So this is the Jinjo Village. It's all jacked up as shit. Oh, and these are, like, teleporters. Let's see. They'll tell me what it is, I'm sure. It's like a fucking bunker hole or something. What is it called? Silos! There we go. Okay. So the world map is pretty fucking huge in this game. So that's to get, like, from area to area. The way it works is when you go into a level, again, like Super Mario 64, that game you jump in a painting. There'll be something similar in this game. You'll get to a world. You gotta fill in enough puzzle pieces to unlock the world, then you jump in the world, and that, you know, you do all the shit in there, and then you come back out. But the world map in this game, or the hub world, is way fucking bigger. So there's silos like that in the hub world, and I think individual levels have silos as well. More story. We're getting in the meat of it. I don't know what the fuck that thing is. That he's petting right there. I also don't know why he's so goddamn big. Because Jinjos are tiny as shit. They're just another form of collectible in the first game and in this one. Every five you get per level gives you one Jiggy in the level. So they're kind of like the equivalent of the 8 red coins in Super Mario. Except there's only 5. So it's easier. Oh my god, okay, I'm hitting the A button. I'm making an executive decision. The A button's been pressed. Okay, so there's my first Jiggy! Jiggy, 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 Jigsaw. Somebody gave me a Jiggy. Stopped by the office like a year ago. Maybe a little less than that. They made it in wood shop. Pretty fucking awesome. I have it in my living room. It's on my coffee table. No, not on my coffee table. It's on my end table. Very different. The coffee table goes in between the big sofa and the television. The end table goes in the corner in between the love seat and the sofa. Just in case anybody asks you, that's how it works. But nonetheless, that's where my wooden jiggy is. And it looks pretty, pretty, pretty good. Hey, Bottle's house. Let's go tell his wife and kids that he's dead. He's also... was he wearing a fucking Pokemon hat? Because it looked like he was for a second. And I can't remember if he was... It's just dumb, and that's not what he's wearing. Or if he always wore that, and I forget it. Or if they added it in the Xbox Live Arcade version. I mean, there's just so many. I mean, who can tell? Who can tell? Nobody can tell. But there's baddies now. Okay, I'm gonna kill my first guy. Because technically, I didn't kill Klungo. No, I'm not. Never mind. Back to the fucking story. We gotta establish the plot, okay? I'm telling you. You're gonna thank me in part 15. Because you would have been sitting there wondering what the hell is happening. They got a big fucking laser. That's what's happening. Look at it. It's fucking huge. It's like the Death Star. They're all hanging out. Bob control. They mentioned what I think they said what it stood for in the beginning, but you know, I wasn't paying attention because I don't give a shit. I wasn't reading what she was saying, and that was my ugh, and then she just had one too. Good lord. Oh, the big O blaster. That's why it's called Bob. You know what it does? It fucks people up. That's what Gavin would look like if he was a witch. I just realized that. They have very similar features. Tall, lanky, not this chick, the other chick. Ginormous nose, a face I want to punch. He's got everything. His hair is actually about that long, too. If he just dyed it pink, he'd be set. He'd fit the bill. Have you ever seen Leonardo da Vinci in Assassin's Creed 2? It's crazy, right? I played that. Assassin's Creed 2, by the way, great game. Brotherhood, also great. The Ezio trilogy is pretty fucking fantastic. Brotherhood might be the best one. But Leonardo da Vinci's in it? Fucking dude looks exactly like Gavin. And I say this as someone who played the game before I met Gavin. Came out years before I ever met him. I met him, hadn't played it in forever. Somebody pointed it out, like, you know, after the fact, and I was just dumbfounded. I'm like, holy shit. It looks just fucking like him. It's crazy. It's crazy. I think somebody was a fucking Slow Mo's guy's fan. I don't even know if Slow Mo Guys was out yet. But it should have been, and maybe it was. And so they put him in the game. So congratulations to Gavin for, you know, winning Angry Birds and being in Assassin's Creed 2 as Leonardo da Vinci. So this is like a fucking... This is like a GPS satellite death machine. It's like the Death Star, but more pinpointed. Where, like, the Death Star will just blow your planet up. This thing will just fuck your house up. Like, they just ruin the property value. Also, they turned him into a zombie, so that sucks too. But at least the fire is still going. They didn't fuck with that. They fucked everything but the fire up. Oh, God, look at his pet. It's just two fucking eyeballs. No! The poor little thingy thing. And how big is this bitch? They just blasted that whole house, like the ground, the earth, everything. And she got like a nudge on the meter. She's only one person. How much life force do you need, you greedy bastard? It's crazy. This is the final and end assault of the long haul of cutscenes, I think. It's a big game, okay? You didn't fucking watch The Departed and be like, oh my god, when's the movie gonna start? No, you didn't. But you're probably doing that now, and it's pretty, you're pretty in the right for it. I can't really stop you. I saw The Hobbit today, right? The second one, the fucking doo-doo a smog. It's pretty good. Ow, I had my hands up in the air, so he just punched the shit out of me. Ah, fuck, I double jumped, which is not actually an attack. So the main attack I use is the peck there. Forget what the fuck it's called. But you just jump and then hit the X button. It's it's pretty much the best basic attack in the game because you can keep moving, you smack bitches, and it keeps you in the air longer too. So it's kind of like doing a double jump. It doesn't put you quite as far, but you also get to F people up while you're doing it. So that's cool. And there's all kinds of other stuff. There's that thing if you want to like, be like, "Oh God, you killed my father." And then you got six fingers and shit. But I'm just gonna run to the bottle's house and tell his family that he's fucking dead. No, I'm not gonna do that. How do I use that? Nope. Okay, that's how you shit an egg out. That's how you shoot an egg. That does that. There we go. Okay. So using the gold feathers make you invincible. They just drain like every one or every like 2 seconds, it drains one feather. And the red feathers are what you need in order to fly. When you get to a flight pad, you just hit the A button, you fly up in the air, and then every time you flap your wings, it costs one red feather. You, what's up? How you doing? Oh, hey, just shooting the shit. Just, you know, just... Nice curls, nice curls. Keep quiet. We just won't tell her that her husband's dead. That's the best way to deal with the situation. Oh, man, you can't... He didn't come home. What a son of a bitch! Why are you doing that? Why would you... Nah, you know. Maybe we can save him, guys. Okay, that's all I'm saying. Like, if we band together, you know, we figure this thing out, maybe we can pull it off. Oh, look, he's got a little Donkey Kong. Get it? You see the tie-in? Because it's rare, and they made that game, too. Pretty fun game for the Nintendo 64, Donkey Kong 64, but convoluted as fuck. It's just you gotta play every level 5 fucking times. Which, it gets old after a while, I'll be honest. Did he give me the goggles? He did. I wasn't paying attention. I knew he gave it to me, but I just wasn't paying attention. Okay. How do we use the goggles? Is it the Y button? Oh, God, he knew. Is it up? Yeah, it is the Y button. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Can I zoom in and out? No? Maybe this isn't this, you know, whatever, I don't give a shit. Alright, so I talked to the wife, I talked to the kid. He's got a second kid that I'm gonna disappoint. Your father's dead, as well. Got a sweet Joanna Dark in the background there. Poster on the wall. Shout out to, why the fuck, Joanna Dark? What the fuck am I talking about? No! Jesus! I think it's Juno is her name? Maybe that's why I went with Joanna, because it's a J. It's a chick from Jeff Force Gemini. I believe it's Juno. Or no, wait, maybe that's the dude. Fuck! Definitely not Joanna Dark, though. I lost my mind for a second there. It's Jet Force Gemini, Nintendo 64 game. I'm gonna hit the Y button, and I'm gonna look at it. Yup, it's her. Hey, you, what's your name? No, the dude's name's Juno. So what the hell is your name? There's Juno, and then there's the dog, and then there's you. And I don't remember your name. That game's fucking awesome, by the way. Would love for a sequel to that. Fantastic. Check that out, too. I don't know if that's on Xbox Live Arcade. I want to say it is, but I think I might be fucking making that up. I'm pretty sure I'm making that up. I apologize if I made it up. Fucking put a fucking jigsaw for a guy's head. You know, why not? It's not going to matter much in this world. All this shit's fucked up. Everything's all fucked up. So here's the first world. And like I said, so you can tell, it's closed. They're not open. They're not open for business. So that tells you how many jigsaws you need to open the bitch up. You need one. Or that tells me how many I have. It's one or the other. It doesn't matter because that's what it is. I have one and it costs one. Shocking, I know. The first world. I hope I didn't spoil it for you. I'm almost dead here. Give me that health. Give me that health. All right, we're almost... I'm telling you, hold on to your seats. We're almost in a level. I'm going to pop into this temple real quick. I'm going to slap down a jiggy, open a door, and then bam, we're in a level. And then... maybe something will happen. You know, we'll see. I don't know. I can't make any promises. I'm just but a humble bear and bird. I'm scratching my nose. Man. Itchy. I'm allergic to something in here. You fucking better open that door for me. Oh, sorry. I believe you have to do a little puzzle every time to open a level. In the first game, you just had to slap the fucking thing. Like, in the board. It was a puzzle on the wall, but you didn't have to solve shit. I think you have to do a mini game every time this one. And they get harder as you go. So that'll be fun to look forward to. I'm gonna fuck up the later levels over and over again. I'm a fucking idiot. I'm already throwing up in my own mouth from disgust. It looks shiny as shit, though. I remember that as a kid, just being like, it's fucking shiny! Everything's so shiny! The floor is fucking shiny! And this is fucking shiny! This is so shiny! That's what I thought as a kid. I may have been a bird as a small child. I don't know. Right, so here's the challenge. You're the hand, grab the pieces, slap it on. This is actually a minigame from the first one. And you get an achievement for completing the entire fucking thing in the first game. Come on, come on. There we go, okay. So, I think if we stick together, we can figure this one. Oh my god, I'm just like, oh, I'm like Rain Man right here. Oh, get in there, get in there! There we go. Never happened to Rain Man, Jesus. Oh, woo! With only 87 seconds to spare. Barely pulled it off. And that's how you unlock the worlds. And then, well, that's how you pay this guy to do a spell to then unlock the world, I guess. This is like his little, his crystal ball. He's getting some balls up in here.
Behold the power of the mighty wiggy.
Wooded Hollow. I guess that's the name of the area I was in. I don't fucking know. I don't fucking care. You pay attention. You pay attention. You love it. You love it so goddamn much. Alright, just wanna strip in. Oh shit! I just thought the door was gonna open, not get fucking blasted. Well, okay, never mind. I guess it did open. Fair enough. Banjo is—he's just amazed. He's dumbfounded. He's shocked. Oh yeah. Yeah. Here we go. Here we go. Oh, shit. So, every time you get a shitload of jiggies, you come back here, and that's how you open up more worlds. So, on the left there, he says four. You need four more before you can even open up the next one. It says I have one, although I thought it got spent when you had it, so I should have zero. But apparently not. I'm dumb, because the game says I have one. So, welcome to the first fucking world. That's right. These are basically like the silos, except they're just warp pads inside the world. And there's usually, I think, like, four or something, and you just hop on and it kind of just teleports you around and shit. But, that's the, this is the fucking general idea. Here's the game. So this, every world is themed in some manner. Obviously, this is like a, you know, a Mayan stone, you know, temple-y theme. And these are notes. They're pretty lenient on notes in this game, especially in the beginning. So The little pads of notes are worth 5 each. As you can see, I'm getting fucking 5 each, which is crazy. Because there's only 100 in each level. And individual notes are just worth 1. Fuck. Oh, wrong button. Like, there's already... I know there's a way to kill these things. I just can't remember how to do it. So I'm just going to keep running past them. Ooh, there's a dude over there. That's where this asshole is. I think Jamjar is his name. He hangs out in those little fucking things. And when you get enough notes, he'll tell you how many you need when you get it over there. That's the dude that teaches you new abilities in every level. So he'll give me something stupid that I need. Or something awesome. I just wanted to insult him. So you don't need to collect nearly all of the notes or jiggies in the game. But why the fuck wouldn't you? I mean, come on. You just need to get, like, a good percentage of them. Like, you saw right there, he teaches you this for 25 notes. He's fucking talking. He's talking. Right, and he's dead. Just fucking teach me the move, man. Teach me the moves, man, come on. Yeah, there we go. Give me some fucking training. God damn it. Still going. He's basically calling his cousin. I think he was his cousin. I didn't pay attention. A fucking busta. After he's died. Not speaking very well of the dead, I must say. Okay. Hey, I got enough notes. Because I left and came back. Okay, give me the move. Egg aim. Oh, so yeah, you could never go first person in the first game. You could shoot the eggs out of your mouth or out of your asshole, and that was it. So now you can actually aim with your fucking face. Check this out. Nope. Check this out. There we go. Look at this. Whoa, dude, I'm playing like GoldenEye. Down, 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 down. Oh, job! Oh, fuck. How do I get out? Okay, there we go. That was fucking crazy, wasn't it? Looks like I was 007 for a moment there. That's Mumbo Jumbo's hut. Now, as I said, in the first game, he transformed you into various creatures and shit. so you could do challenges and get jigsaw pieces and shit in the level. In this game, I preferred it in the way in the first one, but in this one, you actually swap characters with him, so you run around as Mojo, and he fucking sucks. Like, he can't do shit, but you need him to turn on a few pads, like little Mojo pads, so he'll run up on him, and then he'll do a stupid magic spell, and you need his ability somehow in the level. It's just fucking annoying, because a lot of times you'll grab him and you don't need him, and then it's like, oh, I gotta push a button with Banjo first, then you gotta fucking go back get Banjo, then you need Mojo, so then you go back, and it's a whole fucking thing. Now, sometimes you gotta do shit to get Jiggies, like do a mini game or break something with a certain ability, and a few of them are just hanging out in the level, like that one. So there we go, boom! Fucking Jiggy number one. Pretty good start, right? This is, we're blazing through this level. I'm excited to be playing Banjo-Kazooie again, or Banjo-Tooie, to be more specific, because that's what this is. It's such a fucking good game. Highly recommend it. Definitely check it out. I think this is worth like 20. I don't remember. Yeah, look at that. So that's already 100, which is fucking ridiculous. So this first level was like fucking eating doo-doo off a platter. They just put every single fucking note in front of you. Achievement. I think that was for getting, yeah, that's for getting one of every kind of collectible. So those bitches are the Jinjos I was talking about. Every 5 of them in a level gives you a jigsaw piece. But also in this game, because there's this whole Jinjo village bullshit, every time you get a specific color of a Jinjo, like I just got the red one, it goes back to his house. And each house has X amount of Jinjos. Like, there's like 7 red Jinjos or some bullshit. And when you get all of them in the overworld, you get an overworld jigsaw piece as well. Because there's also shit to collect in the overworld, or the hub world, not just the levels. That thing up there, that honeycomb piece, you get 2 of those. There's usually 2 per level. I think there's 2 in every level. If you get 6 of them, you increase your health by 1. So you want to collect them because they make your health get big. I'm gonna fuck these flies up first, though. I wonder if I should shoot some. Maybe that's... No. Go ahead, hit what? There we go. You're gonna get bipped. You're gonna get bipped. God damn it. Okay, right trigger, right? There we go. Oh, I shot him in the fucking face. Okay, so this is an interesting honeycomb. I don't know if this is the randomizer or what the fuck this is. Oh, this is a skill stop. So this thing is easy as shit to use, but it can fuck you in situations. Normally, if you get 1 honeycomb piece, you get 1 health and that's it. But if you look on the left there, you see how it builds up? You get whatever you're at when you hit X. So when it gets to the last one, hit X, and you get full health. It's super easy to do, and it'll save your fucking life. But oh man, if you fuck that up and get 1 health, you fucked yourself, because that'll be bad. Come here. There we go. Controls are not the tightest in the world. Oh, dude, he was right over me. Look at that, dancing cow. He's happy, I'm happy. He's probably gonna give me a fucking jigsaw piece if I know this game, and I believe I do. Oh, look at that, he shit it out right behind him. Gonna get the jigsaw, gonna get the honeycomb. We're doing pretty good. It's a good day. Everybody's so goddamn happy in these games. They're always jumping and shit. They're either extremely happy or extremely sad. When people are sad, boy, are they fucking sad. They're always crying and shit. Okay? Grabbing a ledge might be an ability you learn in this game, if I'm not mistaken. Or you just have to fly the fuck up there with a jump pad somewhere. But, as you see, I can't fucking reach that right now. Which is total bullshit. But I'll just move on. So, the earlier levels should be pretty easy. They're generally smaller, and they get, you know, larger and more complicated. But I should be alright just kind of wandering around collecting shit. But the later levels will, they'll take some time to clear. Oh, here's one of the mumbo things I was talking about. So, in this level, for example, if you pop on this thing, I believe you pull that fucking statue out of the ground, and you can run around and, like, smash shit. I think that's actually what you need to fuck these statues up. And to kick this fucking thing, because it just looks like something that needs to get kicked. Look at it. Would you see that thing and not kick it? Because I'd kick the shit out of it. And then to replace Mumbo, because he no longer turns you into shit, there's another chick, Mumbawumba, and she basically does that exact thing. So she takes over Mumbo's job, and he just fucking runs around. And I think you need tokens for both of them. You can hear Jinjo's whistling when they're nearby, because I just heard one. They'll whistle and be like, help me! They're gonna save my ass! Like that bitch right there. Don't worry. He's not drowning. Somehow. God damn it. Alright, the swimming is inverted. It took me like 6 tries to figure it out, but I got it. don't get up there. At least you don't have to watch them go back to their house every single time. I was kind of wondering that. I couldn't remember if that happened or not. It doesn't. Okay. Yeah, so climbing on a ledge is definitely an ability. And one I probably get in this level. Whenever you get to Jam Jar, the dude that teaches you the moves, when he teaches you the last move, he'll always tell you, hey, bitch, there's no more moves you're going to learn in this level, so get the hell out of here. Like, get out of my face. Fuck off. And I'm like, okay, good truce. Oh, my God, I don't need to read the sign. I know what it says. It says, get mumbo jumbo and hit the fucking B button. Okay, I got it. I got to start unlocking some shit, right? Get some doors open. Throw some doors on this bitch. Ooh, I'm going to go in there first. Or unless it's, I can't get in there, then I won't. What is this? Spring shoes? No, that's it. This is a little, like, honeycomb, hive, like a beehive thing. So there's usually, like, three or four honeycomb pieces inside that. So we need health. Bust that fucker open. All right, I don't see where the fuck I'm going, so I'm just going to go hit up Mumbo. See what this foo's got to say. I think you need tokens to use him, which I don't have any. Oh, never mind. There's one right there, because I'm dumb. Well, actually, I think this is for Mumbo Wumba. But I don't fucking remember. I don't remember who the fuck uses what anymore. Let's go. Find out. Everybody wants some kind of stupid collectible. You can't just, like, fucking take money. Just take gold, okay? Fuck! Wait. There we go. Yeah, I already said that. I told everyone that's what you'd have to do. Oh, yeah. There you go. So these little globos are used for you to swap with Mumbo. You just fucking chuck them in his sack. Where he does God knows what to him. Eats him, fucks him, I don't know. What do you think the guy's into? He lives in a fucking house that looks like his head. He's probably into some weird shit. I'll fucking chuck it in though, because it ain't mine. I mean, I do need to get some jiggies. So, I feel you. Globo, but I want to get the jiggies. Alright. Yeah. You want to see the mighty Zap? He's fucking bigger than Banjo-Tooie, which is always weird. Like, when I run off, I'm just like, holy shit! It just looks bizarre how big his fucking head is. So that really doesn't do shit to enemies. Most enemies, it stuns them, I think. Doesn't even kill them. Asshole doesn't have double jump. He's got no abilities. He just sucks. You just want him to run to his stupid little pad, do his little magic thingy, and then, be done with his ass. Somebody chasing me. It's over here. Oh, shit. See, like, right now, I'm already like, God damn it. If I had fucking Banjo, I'd get the moves. He's gonna tell me to fuck off. He actually calls you a fucking weirdo. He doesn't give a shit. I think there's fall damage in this game. Oh, I was gonna say, let's find out. Landed in the water. Don't have to. Planned it, obviously. I mean, I don't even know if this dude can climb. Can you climb? You cannot climb. He can't do shit. He sucks. I'm gonna go get a giant monkey statue, though. Dun, 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 dun. Bum, 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 bum. All right, here we go. I don't even know where the fuck Mumbo Wumba is. She probably in one of them doors. There's always some kind of fucking stupid time limit, too, with this thing. Which isn't very challenging, because you can just do it over and over again. It's just kind of like, you just want to make sure you do everything while you have it, because it just sucks when you go back to having Banjo, and then you realize you missed one thing. It's like, fuck me, I didn't kick a door open. I also don't know why he sounds rusty, like metal. He's a giant fucking golden statue. I don't know why he'd be, like, creaking. But that's fine. Yeah. I got 75 seconds. Run! So I'm just gonna run over here, I'm gonna kick this fucking thing right in the face. Hey, bitch! Boosh! Eat my fucking foot! So whenever there's a number of things, like those dudes, there's five or six or whatever, usually you get a jiggy when you kill them all. There's usually something like that in every single level, like, fuck up every one of these guys, or break every one of these things. Just, it's all about breaking shit, man. Bringing down the system. Down with the sickness, and also the system. Boosh! Kick your fucking face. Come over to this door, and you lock me out. Boosh! Kick a fucking hole in your door. I don't give a shit. Monkey statue, don't care. I'm gonna kick this guy in the face, too, and I'll probably get something. I think that's it. Oh, I'll try kicking that door up top, too. Ugh! Your face got fucking demolished. Can I kick this? I think this is like an arena, and I actually need to be like a little dude to get in here, so that's probably not gonna work. It's not gonna work. My foot went through it, though. That was pretty cool. Fuck. I don't know if I missed one of the statue things. The spitty things. I don't think I did. But I didn't get you. I'm gonna kick this guy. Hang on. Oh, yeah, boy! Right as time was running, I kicked him right in the ass. And then it always gives you the sad music, like, wah, 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 wah. You suck. Considering these things are still alive, I'm assuming there was more and I missed one, I guess? Because generally when you bust them up, they don't come back. That kind of defeats the whole purpose. So let's do it again, now that I wasted my first 75 seconds. Cannot skip this, cannot skip this. Do-do-do-do, holding buttons, pressing. Oh, shit, I can jump? Man, I mean, why didn't anybody tell me? I would have been flying the first time. Look at this. Woohoo! Woohoo! Oh, okay. Careful there. Hurt my knees. Kick your head. I don't know. These guys might not give you anything. Could be wrong. I just don't know. It's an adventure that we'll figure out together. I definitely need to be transformed to go in that thing over there. The music's always pretty catchy in this game too. I think it's different for every world, more or less. So it's some kind of theme, you know, classic Nintendo, happy-go-lucky. You're killing everything and just murder and mayhem. But you know why? You know you don't gotta. You know, doesn't mean you can't have a good time doing it. Is there one up here? I'm climbing up here. Hey, one of you bitches up here? Oh! 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 Fuck! Jesus, get out of the water! Oh, I'm gonna go walk. Can I fucking breathe? Oh, yeah. I also might have to get back to the pad in time, like, for the things to count as broked. Which I fucked up again. Because he told me to come back to the pad, and I'm getting the failure noise. So let me try it one more time. I'll waste your time. I'll waste my time one more time. I'll kick those three dudes in the face, because it doesn't look like I can go anywhere else. And then I'll come back to my fucking thing, and I'll see if I get any rewards. If not, I'll be like, this is a broken system. I'll fucking scream it. And then I'll... Oh, shit, on my face! I also didn't kick this door. Two fucking times I did this, and I didn't kick this door. Fucking stupid! Boosh! Well, the fucking dude's probably in here! Crazy guy, that's why I didn't get it. Look at this! Look at this! Oh, don't mind me. Don't mind me. I'm just walking along. I don't know what the fuck I'm doing. Out of my way, bitches! Fuck! Okay, I'm sure I have to kick all these fucking things in one run then. Which means I have to go back the other way, because there's two I fucking missed. God damn it! I'm gonna have to do it again! Fuck! So you probably gotta get all three out of there. I mean, I'll haul ass back. I don't think I can make it. You gotta get all three out there, then come in here, then get the two in here, or however many there were. Kick faces. There's Mumba Wumba. She'll transform your ass into a little, like a little stone dude, and then you can compete into games. There's a lot of, like, sports and fun activities that these guys do, and it's all just a good time, pretty much hanging out. Can't fucking believe I fucked that up. God damn it. Trial and error, kids. That's what it's all about. Jesus Christ. This is the first fucking level, and I had to do this four fucking times. Dude, I only have, like, two jiggies so far. Jesus. All right, this is it. Blazing speed now. Haul ass up here. I fucking better get something for this. I'm not gonna get something, am I? Oh shit! And I just realized something too. I'm gonna have to do it again. I bet. I think I can use the warp pads with this fucking dude. And if I can, the trick is to fucking kick all these bitches and then warp inside. But I don't know if I can do that. If I fuck this up again, then I guess I'll try that. But maybe I'll have enough time because the door is right next to this one. I got 40 sets. Plenty of time. Go, you son of a bitch. Go, you son of a bitch. I'm not gonna make it. God damn it. Why do you do this to me? Why do you do this to me? Even if I just transported from the top back to the bottom, I think I might have enough time. 25 seconds. It's like a Nicolas Cage movie. Gone. gone in 25 seconds or something. Go, you son of a bitch! Run! Run! You've got 15 seconds to smash! Oh, they're right over here. Go, 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 go! Go, you son of a bitch! I'm not gonna make it. I'm not- you motherfucker. You motherfucker. Oh, kick the other one! Kick the other one, you son of a bitch! God damn it! God damn it! Fuck my ass in the bits! Fuck! Guys, did you see where I fucking missed that by 1 second? Fuck my ass in the bits! I'm reiterating that. Alright, so I'm gonna try to use the little warp pad here. Cause if I can use the warp pad, I'll make it, cause I only need 1 second. And there's one up top here, and there's one right down by that door. If I can't use the warp pad, then I guess I gotta move fucking quicker anyway then, right? Fucking Christ, 1 goddamn second. Bullshit is what it is. Welcome to part one, hour and a half long. I don't fucking care. I don't give a fuck. Well, yeah, fuck it, whatever. Okay, teleport, go, go, change, go. Do it. Nope. And now I fucking wasted this turn too. I'm gonna just kill myself. Oh, you fucking son of a... Fuck! Alright. So I'm just gonna walk back down. I don't know if there's any way to just abort in this fucking thing. I don't think so. You either have to just get on the pad or just wait for time to run out. Good lord. Level 1. There's some challenges that are difficult in this game. And I'm not saying this one is, because it's not. I'm just an idiot. But... I know there's some button shit later that's a real pain in the ass. Alright. Now you're starting to piss me off, you fuck. I hauled anus last time, and you missed it. Don't fucking embarrass me again! Alright! Get your ass up there, you fuck! You gotta be strict with them sometimes, with these giant statues, you know. They think that they're the boss, and they push you around, but you gotta let them know. I also wonder if jumping off the top is faster than walking back around. Now I don't fucking know. Now I'm questioning everything. Is there a god? Who's to say? Let's just fucking jump off. Fuck it, right? What did I think I went through the door with like 27 seconds last time. So if I do better than that, it'll be worth it. Oh, damn it. Damn it. If I made that, it would have been totally worth it. But then I did this. So now it's not worth it, is it? I'm gonna have to fucking cut this shit! This is taking fucking forever! Why are you taking forever, you bastard? Alright, let's examine this closely. Where can I drop off? Can I drop off from up there? If I walk all the way over there... Okay. Okay, here's what I'll do, right? I'll go up there, I'll fall down, and I'll walk right up the ramp. And then we'll get it next time. That's the time that we're gonna get it. This is it. I will fucking murder someone if I don't get it next time. If I don't get a Jiggy for this, there is gonna be hell to pay, I swear to God. I am gonna ruin everything with my anger. Attempt number 6. 5? I lost count. I honestly lost count. What time is it? How long? Well, how many days has it been? Fucking win-win for you. Oh, man. It's Monday already. Actually, this might come out on Monday. Who the fuck knows? I don't know. It's already 4 o'clock. Or almost. Yeah, Central Time. It's 4 o'clock. Would really help if there was a sprint button with this dude. Okay, kick you in the fucking face. Walk off. No heroics, no jumping. I got caught on the ledge a little bit there. I feel like that burned me. Okay, here we go. Dude, now we're fucking hauling anus. Way ahead of schedule. Way! Oh, dude! The schedule's so far behind me, I can't even fucking see it. I think I'm like 3 seconds faster than I was, so not too much better. But, I did miss it by 1 second last time. Fucking, you know what they say, 958th time's a charm. Unless I just fuck this up somehow. That guy's gonna kill me, he's gonna hit me with a club and I'm gonna die. There's 2 more abilities for me to learn. So there's one in here, and then there's that one on the cliff ledge. Kick you in the fucking mouth. Oh my god, look at this. Beautiful. Look at that. Look at that. There we go. Are you kidding me? Is there one more? What? You son of a bitch! Fuck! Alright, so I think there's one more. I don't know where the fuck it is. It's gotta be inside, and you have to be able to fucking... You gotta be able to use this dickhead to teleport or something. So, for now, I'm just gonna switch back to Banjo-Kazooie, because I'm wasting all my goddamn time doing nothing. You motherfuckers. I can't fucking believe I... Oh my god.
Part one, off to a fucking great start in part one. I fucking love it.
I did run on this thing, right? Okay. I did. God damn it. Whoa, my shadow is scaring the shit out of me there. I might have to kill part one before I even finish this level. Okay. Oh, I got sorry. Let me hop back on my seat. And then my soul goes back into my body, apparently. Oh, shit. Who's blowing up my spot? Fuck. That means I... Fuck! I almost walked into the wall again. That means I got a text. Blowing up my spot. That's like lingo. You might... I don't know if you've heard of it. Okay, let's get this fucking ledge grab ability. We got the ledge grab. I got the red feathers are open now. There's another ability inside. Let's do something useful. Like, not waste all of our goddamn time, which is what I just did for the last 19 minutes. Okay, blah, 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 blah. Oh, this, yeah, so this enables you to do the first-person mode, which you may have seen in the episode of Versus, where I challenged Ray to Banjo-Tooie, which had multiplayer. I'd never played it my entire life, and they're actually pretty fun. I mean, it's most of the games from the single-player game that are used in various levels, but one of them is, like a first-person shooter thing, which I think might have been in that temple up there. And I just chose not to go in it because I'm a fucking busta. Where's the, where the hell was the fucking thing at? There was the, honeycomb around here somewhere. So here's the flight pad. So you hit A and you just fly up on that bitch. And then when you hit A again, you just go up. So it's, I mean, you're, like, always stocked on red feathers because they're fucking everywhere. And you pretty rarely use them. So, yeah. That's... I got nothing to say. Don't run out of red feathers. It's hard to... You suck. If you run out of red feathers, you suck. Yeah, get in there, boy. Get in there. There we... They can't tell you shit while you're in the air, so he waited till I landed. Oh, that was it. Okay. He just said it's an extra honeycomb piece. That's all you need to know. Get out. Ow. I'm gonna head inside, grab the other ability, get on those pads inside, maybe fucking... You must be able to teleport this thing, because I'm almost certain that kicking those things gives you something. Game sure made a fool out of me, though, I tell you what. Give me the gold! Oh, they're gonna bust some dudes up. Yeah, remember me? Boosh! You got busted up. You gonna let me grab some ledges? You gonna let me grab some ledges? Aw, grip grab! Some people call it, you know, using your fingers. But today we'll call it a grip grab. Oh yeah, and he gives you fucking full health, too, when you talk to him. Shit, is there more for me to learn in this level? Damn! Oh, look at that. Just like Mario, if you, you know, any of the 3D versions, if you hold the left trigger and do a backflip, you jump higher. What's up? No. Talk to him. There you go. Aw, shit, son. So you gotta be... I think those are... They're called stonies. You gotta be a stony. LOL. Should've got Ray in order to talk to him. Which is conveniently what the chick turns you into. Boosh. Stuck with you, and then you suck, and then there's more shit over here. This will turn you into thing. So it's kind of the similar thing with Mumbo, where when you get transformed into something, you want to really do as much as you can with it, because you don't want to keep fucking getting transformed into shit over and over again, because it's just fucking annoying to go back and forth. I don't see another one of these fucking things. The statues. But I imagine there's a sixth one somewhere. Look at this guy hiding up here. You hiding? Oh, shit! Oh, wow, okay. What am I doing here? Am I gonna shoot you in the face? Well, to be honest, I did. Oh, and then she said the same thing. Oh, I gotta be fucking sneaky. Okay. Okay, so then this fucker naturally just spit it back out. I don't know if you can just tiptoe and that'll do it, but let's figure it out. I'm sure I'll fuck it up 100 times, just like the other thing that went nowhere. It's, because this has different terrain on it. You can see it's all, like, sticks and shit. God damn it. Yeah, so once you, it looks like once you step on it, he gobbles it up. So even here, seeing the whole thing's covered in it, you probably have to fly in, I would imagine, and just grab it with, you know, just land on top of it. Or you need to use the stony, like the transformation thing. Hang on, wait. Nope. Fuck. Yeah.
All right.
That's a dude that comes out of the wall. Fuck. Nope. Didn't mean to do that. Oh, God. Those things up there, they're like monsters that'll come out of the wall and they'll get you. So be ready to whack them when you're crawling across the wall. They're bitches. God damn it. Something is fucking itching the shit out of my nose. It's crazy. I'm like ripping my fucking face off here. I'm trying to do Banjo-Tooie. Not doing a very good job of it. Jesus Christ. I mean, this level's like, holy crap. What do we got so far? Not much. I got a bunch of Jinjos. Oh, wow. Okay, so there's 3 honeycombs level. We have 2 fucking Jiggies. There's I know I can get 9. Christ. I did get all the jam jars. And I got 1 of the Globos. Maybe Mumbo and Wumba both use Globos. Let's find out. To Wumba's house. Because I'm fucking running out of ideas of what to do. Holy shit. I'm surrounded by jigsaws I'm not collecting. If I have fucking, 2. I think when you select, you get a little menu here. Yeah, there you go. I fucking could have swore you could transform on those fucking things or teleport with the statue thing. Just don't know. Oh, whoa. See, I heard it. I heard the thing giggling. Sound is definitely important in this game. The game gives you a lot of audio clues as to where collectibles are and shit. And to when people go, because it just sounds funny. It just sounds funny. That's big heap welcome to you too. Way more extensive world 1 than Banjo-Kazooie, believe it or not. I beat the first, not playing the game in a year or something, I beat the first world in, I think, 13 or 14 minutes when I did a Let's Play on it. Time's looking a little longer than that for this one. So, ah, fuck! I gave her the fucking thing and then didn't transform. My bad! Let me head back in there. Try this again. Oh, right. I'm just gonna plop in there. Oh, now you're a little banjo fucking stony thing. The only annoying thing is, like, about this shit is the fact that you always have to come back. It's a lot of times I did it in the first game. If you can plan it in the second game, which is harder because there's so much more to do, but if you get your final jiggies with your transformed dude, when you leave the world, if you walk away far enough, you'll just transform back, like, because you can't walk around the whole world map in these forms. So that saves you a trip to go back, but that's about it. What did he just say? I was talking. I wasn't even listening. All right. Like, the things that I was fucking kicking, there wasn't shit underneath those things. You're a fucking liar. Son of a bitch. Get up the stairs. Really? I gotta jump? Yeah, this thing's not gonna be able to get up there. But this thing will run in here, which I believe is a little competition. Hopefully the gate will open up for me. Open sesame. Open up. God damn it! I needed to fucking kick it. I needed to kick it with the fucking statue. See what I'm talking about? I'm talking about fucking myself over here. So now, not only do I, like, did I fuck myself with the stone thing, I need to change back into Banjo. Can't run in the quicksand with this thing. I was testing it. You can't. So I need to change back into Banjo, change back into Mumbo, kick the fucking thing, and then go back to Banjo, then come back to this fucking thing to get in there. Which is why this makes me want to blow my brains out, having not played it in forever. Because it's all about just order. You know, you just gotta do shit in the right order. And clearly, I'm not doing that. Fucking go over here at least. Christ, I think there's something I can do outside. Because he will not fucking train. I don't think you can swap with him in this form. But fuck it, I'll try it because it's right there. But after I check this bitch out. You know, I was discouraged because I tried kicking this thing, and what happened? My fucking foot went right through it. But no, not the other thing. And now it's not even open. I don't remember how to play this fucking game at all. What am I doing with my life? Fuck. Hang on. I know there's still another thing. Jesus Christ. And I didn't even go in here yet, did I? I went through the other one. I don't think I went in that one. Watch where you're fucking shooting that shit, all right? I'm going to a very important game. I'm going to do kickball or some shit. Where is it? Is it over here? Yeah, there it is. This guy won't let you true unless you look legit like this.
Hey, who had you?
Busta. All right. So here's one of the little mini games. I think it's just like kickball. Just shut the hell up and let me in. I got time for this shit. We're already like 48 minutes into this video. I have two fucking jiggies. Two, man, two. That's crazy. It's embarrassing. Can't believe I'm doing this to myself. Don't worry, guys. I'll do some reading. Before the next part, I'll do some research. I'm not gonna do that. I'm just full of shit. I'm just kidding. I'm not gonna fucking do anything. Fuck you. What's down here? I'm gonna go down here. I promise I'll explore a lot and waste time. Oh, I'm in the arena. What is this? I got the ball? What the hell am I doing with it? I'm not even playing the game. I'm gonna kick him in the face. Kick him in the, kick it in. Kick it. How do you kick it? Nope. Oh, God! Don't mind me. When I do this! Oh, yeah, look at that. They're just so impressed with my skills. Glad I came down here to do that. That looked incredible. God, I'm such a fat little... Humpty the Dumpty. Just fucking blow my brains out. I look like Humpty Dumpty, but, like, made a rock. Mayan kickball! Oh, my God, no. I'm not fucking training. Jesus Christ, just let me play the fucking game already. I'll lose this 100 times anyway. Alright. I like how I just walk in off the street and I'm in the quarterfinals. There must not be very many teams. Also, when the team's one person. So you grab the thing, and then you shoot the thing in the goal, and that's about it, I think, right? How do you kick it? Oh, there we go. There we go. Wasn't hitting the right button. Or do I... Oh, well, I want to kick it in my own goal. I swear, I think I did the exact same thing in Versus. Fuck me. Yeah, okay, we're going to do a bit of recovery now that I remember how to actually play the game. No. Hey. I've done enough kicking in other people's goals. Give me the ball. Give me that. Oh! What? Damn it! Oh, come on, shithead. Kick the thing in. Kick it in. There you go. One more. Get it in there. There you go. Holy shit. I almost let that one get away from me, folks. Right trigger kicks. Kick it in your own goal. Now you know. I did something right. Oh, they're doing the thing, like, classic. Left, right, then center. Center's last. Save the best for the last. At least I know I'm getting a jiggy for this. It's been, like, 28 minutes since I got one. It's been pretty embarrassing. I don't really care. That fucking face. He is delighted. I'm telling you. Everybody's so delighted about everything. So reds, obviously, subtract points. So that piece of shit just kicked it in my goal, so I lost 1 point. Because he's a piece of shit, and he knew. So fuck you. Kick it in your goal. How do you like that, chump? Chomsky, Noam Chomsky. I'll kick reds in all your goals all goddamn day. Oh, can't stop me. Oh, did you want this? Can you get out of the way, guys? I can't get to my goal. Okay, there we go. No, shit. That's all right. No one will have it. Jesus Christ, guys, get some points. This is embarrassing. What? Oh, fake out. Get over there. Oh, nope, fuck it, whatever. I don't even care, I ain't even mad. Semifinals were easier than the quarterfinals. All right, we've battled our way from the ground up. You've been there with me the whole time. Let's fucking finish this off with some stellar points, and let's take this baby, let's take it home. It's also the exact same team every time. even though I'm winning the final, like, the I won the quarterfinals and the semifinals, it's the same four teams. So what the hell was the point? Clearly, they made it anyway. I don't know what the fuck this does, if it's a lot of points or it's no points. Oh, no, that's right, yeah, the bomb, so the bomb fucks up other people. Like, you hit, like, those dickheads all just hit each other with the bomb because they're stupid dickheads. Keep that in there. Oh, eat bomb, eat bomb. Oh, I missed, it's okay. It's okay. God, these guys suck. Ray was a lot more challenging than these busters. That's why I'm making it look so easy. I've been training for this. Although Red is fucking tied. Red, no points for you, bro. Bro, no. Are you kidding me, Red? Are you kidding me, dog? Fucking, no, don't let him get it. Don't let him get it. God damn it. God damn it. Fuck. So Red got the best of me, right? Tied, but no, a tie means you lose. Bullshit. I'm sorry, coach. Coach is pissed. Mulligan, don't worry about it. Oh my god. Red is the Red's the one to beat. He's the shyster. Ow! Oh shit. I have no fucking points. Get out of the way! Get out of the way! Get out of the way! God damn it, yellow! Oh, here we go. Here we go. Oh, get past that guy. Kick that in there. Oh, bullshit! You're a piece of shit. Oh, I blasted myself. I blasted myself. Fucking yellow's kicking my ass! Holy shit! Wow! Dude! 14 fucking points! Are you kidding me? Are you kidding me? This is bullshit! Holy crap! I'm walking around the room. I gotta take a breather after that. Oh my god! Oh my god! I just looked at the time. We're like an hour and 15 minutes into this fucking video. I didn't even realize it was going on that long. That's incredible. This video is going to be about 2 hours long. Holy shit. I don't give a fuck. I'm throwing it up. I'm already here. I'm going to win this goddamn kickball game if it's the last thing I do. I'm getting at least like fucking 5 jiggies before this video's over. And you'll endure! Okay? Because it just means the other parts, there would have been 90 parts to the beginning, okay? It's for your pleasure. These videos are ribbed for your pleasure. Why did I kick it towards my own goal? I kicked it right towards my own goal so they could lay it up in my goal, the red one, because I'm fucking dumb. Why am I so dumb? Eat a bomb, sucka. Eat a fucking red. Here we go. This is it. Oh, yellow, eat shit. Grab the thing. It's yellow, it's bullshit, because he's yellow, and the ball's yellow, and it's, like, helping him somehow. There's a red for you. I don't know how that happened. That's crap. Get around him. Shoot! Oh! What?! Fucking are you kidding me?! I thought I had it. I didn't even see purple. Holy crap. I'm losing my goddamn mind during kickball. This is horse shit. Oh, my god. Ray wasn't this good! I got fooled by the quarterfinals and the semifinals. Holy shit! Look, they're just putting the balls closer and closer to me. They're like, holy shit, this guy still hasn't won? Just give him the fucking balls. My god. What more do you want from us, kid? Oh! Yeah, they're like spawning underneath me. Just get them all. Just fuck everybody else. Just get all the yellows. Get the fucking red out of here. Hey! There we go. There we go. Kick it in mine. Fucking eat that. Give me one. Okay, no one is near me. I swear to God, if I lose this fucking game, I'm gonna unleash my fury on something. Holy crap. This part one has just not been my part, ladies and gentlemen. Let me tell you. Fucking finally. Woo! Sports is intense. It's not for the faint of heart. There we go. Jiggy, holy shit, I fucking got 3. Is there anything else I can do with this little prick? Oh, yeah, actually, there's a honeycomb piece I can get near the beginning. Where is it at? There you are. All right, well, there's 2 out of 3. We're making progress. I don't care how long this shit's gonna take. Okay, and this is why these videos go up on the weekends, because they suck. Okay. Okay, I gotta go back to Wumba. There's her thing. I really don't know if I'm supposed to kick all the fucking statues with the thing or not. Like, it's whack. Oh my god. And I wish this guy could jump up the stairs. Well, he can jump up the stairs. I wish he could walk up the stairs. Is it hot in here or is it just me? Are you guys hot? I'm dying in here. I can't believe the microphone's still going. Recording. It's gonna fuck up. I know it is. And then I'll start the game all over again. Hell, I should start it all over again now. Why fucking waste time? I'll just do it now. I'm the bear and bird again. Let's see what I can do with these pricks. I haven't gone through. I know I gotta go back to Mumbo to get the thing to kick the hole in the wall. But I also haven't gone through the other door that I kicked the hole in yet. I don't think. I think the one up here. So let's head in there. There might also be something in the air. Seeing as there's that, there's the flight pad. There might be something besides the honeycomb piece. So I'll probably have to check that out. What the hell's in here? I didn't go in here, right? Okay, I did not. All right. Just checking. Prison compound. Boosh. Fucking squishy bits. Squishy bits. Guess what got squished? Itchy bits. Oh, there's some complicated puzzle shit over there. You see that? There's shit on the floor. See, like, I'm inclined to think that you can teleport because I think the statue's the only dude that can walk across the quicksand until you get the fucking wading boots, at least. Oh, shit. See, this is the thing that I know you can't get this time around. You have to free this dude after you get another ability. Like, you can get inside that cell from another level or some bullshit. I'm not exactly sure. I don't remember. But you can't do it now. Okay, that's it. So it's just nothing? I don't think I can run in there with the... Let's try the invincibility. I don't think you can. You cannot. You cannot. As you saw there. So, no. So the only way you're getting across there is either with the dude or probably with the, with the flight pad. I have no idea what the fuck the order is here. God damn it. I don't know nothing, okay? Maybe it's over here. Do some swimmies. How do I go under again? Is it X? It's X. And then hold A to swim with your little feet, and then press X too. Or maybe you have to learn that ability. But you can learn it somehow. God, this is a long fucking video. Son of a bitch! Okay, so I need the dude over here. This is a big fucking boulder. Ow! Unless I just do this. Can I do this? This is a... Wait, how do I do the pound? There you go. Nope, that wasn't enough. Huh. Yeah, so you have to be able to get the guy in here. I don't fucking know. I'm baffled at my own stupidity. All right, let's check this sign. Maybe this sign will give us some insight. What do you got for a sign? Only a stony can understand what another stony speaks. No shit! Who cares about that? What does it have to do with this? Although this could also be the other thing that maybe I can't get in yet. Maybe this is the thing that I can't break. I'm just making excuses as to why I don't know what the fuck I'm doing. You'll find I do that a lot. That's why I'm an hour and a half into this video. Where's the, what's up here? Ooh, nope. People are gonna be pulling their fucking hair out watching me play. It's so fucking cringeworthy. It's crazy. I don't know how you stomach it. Here's what you do. Just watch it in small doses. Take a breather. You know, nobody expects you to stomach this horrific nightmare all in one part. I mean, it's who would? Oh, can I get up here? Look at this. Fucking secret ledge. What? What? Ba-da-ba-ba-ba. I'm ledging it. Oh, there we go. Look, that's how I get across. I'll do this. Doot, 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 doot. Oh, there's them wading boots I was talking about. They help you wade. So this is an ability you learn from the first game. You learn the ability to put shoes on. And you learn it well, as you can see. Like a champion, just jumping right across. I don't think there's any way to end it, so you just kind of run around until I can get my fucking legs back. There we go. And look at that. Dude, I got that one in less than 4 hours from the last one. That's an improvement. That's progress right there. Now we'll head back. We'll hit that last Mumbo thing. I'll kick something again. You know, maybe I'll pause this game, look stuff up online so I actually figure out how to play the game. It'll be fun. It'll be great. It'll be great. Everything's gonna be great. God damn it. I also wonder if I can use those boots to fucking teleport and then go through the other quicksand. Usually if there's shit you can't get through, there's a thing nearby that lets you get through them. That's how the game works. As in most games. Fucking, remember this guy? Remember, not Mumbo, but the statue? Remember when I did that? Let's do that again for another 19 minutes. I can't even fathom how long of the video that was. That guy should certainly be in the thumbnail. He probably won't be because I hate him so much, but he deserves to be. Which is why he won't be there! Do-do-do-do-do-do-do. I don't know how the fuck to get into the thing up top. Like, it was closed, the door was closed. See, like, that's the kind of shit that happens when you, say, kill all those stone statues. You'd either A, get, like, a jiggy, or B, a door would open. Like, that's something normal that would happen, but I don't fucking remember. It's been a while, alright? I'll probably just get, like, one or two more and then end this. Regroup, tackle the second half of this world next time. I already got the 100 notes, so that's out of the way. Okay, so I gotta go this way. Let's go this way. I'm gonna kick this guy in the face for fun. Kicked your fucking face. How'd you like that? You know he didn't. So can I get on these things? A mashing beam going crazy? No, there's no fucking way you can teleport on those things. I'm calling it right now, okay? I'm calling it. It's Kangaroo Court. Kangaroo Court. Do, 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 do. Fuck you and fuck your quicksand. Also, did I just not walk into this? Should I have just walked into that? Okay, I'm a fucking idiot. Well, I'm glad I came back because I'm stupid and I missed that last time. There we go. I'm gonna kick the shit out of this door. And it better fucking break. There we go. Boosh. That thing exploded. So, I don't know what the fucking point of these damn things are. There's gotta be another one somewhere that you gotta fucking kick. They don't just put shit in the game for nothing. Especially because they reappear once you fucking turn back into, like, a regular size. Or when you turn into Mumbo. What the hell is happening? I'm getting some lag. The fucking multiplayer was kicking in. Did you see that? That was crazy. I was getting disconnected from the server. Alright. Ugh. So now, I can go back through that door. Right? Is that what we're doing? It's not that door, though. It's the door at the bottom. Although, I can just use the pad out here. So this shit. Like, I don't know how to open this fucking thing. Actually, I probably just figured it out. Probably gotta shoot an egg into the fucking mouths on those things. That's what it looks like anyway, so I'm gonna try that. I'm also gonna try shooting these fucking statue things, because they have little jewels on their head, and I don't know if it does anything, but I'll try shooting them in the face with Kazooie. We'll do that for a bit, see how that goes. And then maybe I'll just kind of call it quits, and I'll just go eat some pie for a while I sort my life out. I keep running into that same wall every time. It's like a shadow, and I just think it's a doorway, and I don't know why. Hey. Hey, guy. Give me your face. I'm gonna blast it off. Does that work? Son of a bitch. So that's what I need to fucking do to all these things. At least we figured it out in the video, right? Yeah. So first, let's try feeding these things. Can I feed you? Get fed on. Get fed on. Yup! I'm figuring shit out left and right. Like fucking Sherlock Holmes. The like, much slower, lesser-known version. That figures shit out, like, after it no longer matters. There's also a cheat page up there, if I can climb this bitch. If not, I'm gonna fly up there. And that also reminds me I need to get the jiggy from the snake. Snakey-wakey, artichakey. Alright, let's head in here. I hope it's not, a stony thing, because if it is, it's gonna suck. It's okay, this guy's got fucking blah blah blah. Oh god. Fucking Kazooie. She doesn't give a shit. Alright, what'd you lose, bro? Oh, you see, here we go. This guy's opening doors. How the hell am I gonna get up there? Oh shit. So, if he gives me a timer, I know what I gotta do. Did you give me a timer? You didn't give me a timer, okay. You got to probably use the flight pad to get up there. But naturally, I'm going to want to get the... Oh, look at this. Right? Hiding this up there. I'm going to want to get the note first. Okay, good. So there's the three honeycomb pieces in this world. We got all the notes. I think there's still two more Jinjos left. Bum, 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 bum. See? Now, I shot this fucking thing. Maybe it just doesn't fucking matter. I'm gonna get whacked. Yeah, because that's what happens every time you're gonna fucking shoot him when he's looking at you. Because once you go inside a building, it looks like this shit resets anyway. So I don't know how you'd possibly, like, track them all. It may or may not do something. I don't know anymore. Don't ask me. Just go look it up online for someone who knows what they're talking about. Okay, so the flight pad should be down here. Man, and I'm telling you, this is world one. They get way harder. I'm dumb. I'm not smart. Okay, hop on this baby. Fly up straight to the tippy top. What the hell is up here? Anything good? Can't remember. Oh yeah, there's a fucking jiggy. It's pretty awesome, actually. Okay, here we go. Here we go. I'm flying there. Get whatever I want. Hopefully I can leave through the top. Oh no, it doesn't matter anyway. The cheat page is right there. Because I was going to try and grab it. I thought it was on a different level. It's not. Fly right there. Boop. Grab that. Use that for cheat codes. Oh, he's going to tell you that. So just like in the first game, you find his pages. In the first game, it was like one page per cheat. But in this one, there's way more of them. So it's like every 5 or 10, you get a cheat code along the way. But they're like cool, helpful cheats. Like increase your max health and shit like that. So, it's really more like an upgrade than a cheat. I mean, if we want to get fucking technical. Step on a switch, open the gate, don't know what it did. Although, whatever I want's probably down here. Turn the fucking camera! Okay, it's not. It's definitely, oh wait, is it up here? Hang on. Okay, what am I looking at here? What am I looking at here? So, there's a jump pad over there. Which leads me to believe it's for something. Maybe it is up here. I don't know what the fuck I'm doing. I guess I could have gotten up there before, but I wouldn't be able to get through because there was a gate or something. I don't fucking know. Let's go out this way. Oh, here's some fatty sleeping. Unga Bunga's cave. So this shit, perfect example. This is another world, I believe? I could be wrong. I'm probably wrong. But shit like that happens where a lot of times you can open up a portal and you'll be in another world. So this time around, though, I think if as long as you tiptoe and he'll make the tiptoe animation, you can get the shit without making noise. But you only have to do it on, you know, the, like, sticks right here. And if that doesn't work, then I don't know what the fuck I'm talking about. Oh, yeah, shh. Be quiet. Gonna get the fucking tiki statue. Shh. Fuck! I said be quiet. Damn it. This is the longest video I've ever made in my life. This will be easily be the longest video. Well, no, I guess panels and shit were longer than this. But one of the longest could be the longest video on Let's Play. Right? Most boring too. But still, longest. It counts for something. I'm telling my mom. It's an accomplishment. You shut up, whether you like it or not. Okay, before I go over there again and fuck it up. What the hell is over here? Anything over here? I'm scared. I'm scared. Oh, see this? When they got red eyes? Oh, God! Oh, God, no! That means they'll attack your ass. Jesus. Holy shit. I was not ready for the ferocity of that thing. Here's a split pad. That's an ability you get later on. So, again, that's definitely a thing you have to come back for. Where am I at here? No shit. And there's some kind of ability. You gonna teach me something? Holy shit. Yeah, see, I need 420. So this is going into the other world thing. So I don't have nearly enough fucking, notes to learn whatever the hell it is he's gonna teach me. It might actually be the split pad. I don't know. But we'll worry about that for another time. Because I'm getting distracted, all right? This is already taking long enough. Head over here. Okay. Try not to fuck this up. It's hard. I swear. motherfucker, I'm gonna kill somebody. I'm gonna murder somebody's fucking face. This is gonna take like 100 fucking tries. Oh my god, and he's gotta put me out of the room. Fucking shit. This is why this game's so much fun. It's so challenging. Okay, get your shit together. Get your shit together, Banjo. Might need like another... Fuck. His controller is too fucked. I'm like tapping it and he's fucking me. Like he's just walking when I need him to do this. The difference between the two is outrageous. Between the tiptoe and the slow walk, it's nuts. And there's no button to hold or anything to like make him not walk. It just flips between not moving and running. Because I suck. I also might switch controllers. Okay, hang on. Okay. Motherfucker. I know this is how you get the fucking thing, too. I don't know why I can't just kill the guy. Just shoot him in the head with an egg while he's not looking. He won't care. I'm sitting on top of my... I'm standing on my chair now. Like, I got out of my seat, and I'm standing up on top of my seat. Because I'm fucking getting riled up. Can I just jump over this shit, too? Will that work? I don't think I'd make it. Let's fucking try that, though. Fuck! I almost made it. Okay, next plan. I wonder if I can tiptoe, like, 2 feet onto it, then jump. Or if I can just do it the way I'm supposed to and not suck shit. But I don't think that's likely to happen. Okay, hang on. This whole part is nothing but fucking failure. It's disgraceful. Okay, hang on. Okay. I can't get a fucking inch! God damn it! It's fine. Don't worry about it. It's fine. Fucking audio's still going. You know, this would be the day. I'd be fine if it fucked up. Oh! Video's canceled. Guess I'm not making it, but no. That's not the case. Let me switch controllers here for a second. Give me a second. Hang on. I still haven't switched controllers yet. I don't know what I was doing. Hang on. I'm gonna use Ray's controller. Dude, do you think he's gonna be mad? Hang on, let me sync this controller. My analog stick's too fucked up. Oh, don't turn the Xbox off, dickhead. Okay, doing the sync. Syncing this bad boy up. It synced to fucking controller 1. Are you shitting me? No, you need to be controller 2! Oh my god, everything is just going to shit. Alright, now go to controller 2, you stupid son of a bitch. Okay, so now I'm using Ray's controller. Let's see if it makes any difference whatsoever. It's a nice silver controller. You may have seen it in some videos that he's used it in. You know, maybe it's got a better sneak than mine. Probably not. I'm just looking for an excuse to blame anything but myself. Okay. So far, so good. Oh, I'm fucked. You fucking son of a bitch. God damn it. So close. My thumb is twitching right now. I'm like having a fucking mental breakdown. Also, oh my god. Dude, you're so close. Dude, you're so close. Just keep going. Keep going, you little fuck. You little fuck. Just keep going. Just go a little further. Just go a little further. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on, little baby. Come on, little baby. Come on, my little baby. Oh, my little baby. Oh, my little baby. Holy shit. It was the fucking controller. First try. First try with Ray's controller. What the fuck? What the fuck? This is bullshit. I'm dealing with defective equipment over here. God damn it. Fuck, that was infuriating. Shout out to Ray and his silver controller. Thank you for being here in spirit. You know, I used the way, the MLG way of Ray to guide me, and I did it. And, you know, I'm pretty great. So that's that. Woo! I'm gonna use his controller for the rest of this video, because I don't fucking have time to deal with switching back. I don't know where I'm going with this thing either. I'm just kind of walking around with it. Well, you can't go that way, silly. It's fucking, oh my god. Tell me I needed to lower that first. Where's that? What's over there? That better be the other world. You son of a bitch. Oh, that's right, I gotta go through the 10. Okay. I got scared for a second. I've done this room 800 times. Jesus. Okay. Carry this thing out. Just very slowly. The sun is beaming out there. It's a bright-ass room. Oh, that's the gold room. Okay. And wait. What?! Okay. So, where am I supposed to fucking throw this thing? Are you serious? I can't fucking carry it through there. What the hell am I doing with it? I don't know what the fuck I'm doing with this fucking thing. I can't even put it down. Unless I was still holding it and he just put it away for some reason and he took it back out. Because I can't go through the gate. Let's go back to this. I love this game. It's just great. I played all the time. It's good. I sound like an old person who's never used a television before. Did I do it right? I don't know what's happening. What's going on? What? He better whip it out of his butthole and fucking throw it to this dude. Jesus Christ. It startled me. He was carrying it over his head, and then he put it away, and then he took it back out. And I didn't know what was going on. I'm not a future seer. I don't know these things. Shut the hell up and give me the goddamn jiggy already. Just shut your mouth. Just shut up. Fuck. That's 5 or 6. Oh, yeah. You notice it's gone? Yeah, surprise, surprise. Pebble gone, foo. Big beating. Oh, that's sad. He's gonna get beat for it. It's like, if I gave a shit, I would care. But I don't. I need to find the code for that prison. That's somewhere, the one with the 3 patterns. I'm pretty sure I can open that in this level. And I have not done that yet. But there's also a lot of things I haven't done. Where am I going? Going over here? Here we go. Oh, dude. 7? But I think that's total, so I think it's... What is that, 6 in this level? I want to show your level totals first, not your overall. Oh my god. Okay, wow, there's 3 fucking cheat pages in this level too? Holy shit, I just noticed that. So, maybe about 50%, 60% done with this level, and it only took 2 hours so far. So we're making progress. You know, it's small battles. Is that what, you know, that's the saying, the thing? Is there a saying? Let's say stuff. Hey! I said stuff. Okay, so I guess I can still head back inside where that dude kicked the hole in the thing, because I didn't... Oh, God! I didn't go in there yet. I'm sure these things still give you something I haven't figured out, the spinning statues. But I'll also ignore them. And I guess I'll just head in here and wrap it up, because I'm not going to wander around anymore. Slow start. Don't worry though. Future parts, plenty of stuff to do. I'll be like, I know exactly where I'm going. Oh shit, you know what? I'm pretty sure that these fucking stone bitches give you the password to let that dude out. So that I will definitely just look up online. I mean, do off camera. Because they tell you how to get in there. I could have just used the telepad thing, but I didn't. The warp pad. It's not a telepad. It's like a warp pad plus a telephone. What is this shit? Oh, this is where the fucking cheats are? Well, this is fucking worthless to me. There's not even anything I can do in here. Yeah, that's what I just said. It's not of any use to me. I just said that. Fuck! Okay, so this is where the cheat codes are put in. So you gotta come back to this first world. When you get cheat codes in the outside world, you gotta come back here just to enter them in. Very similar to the second world in the original game, Treasure Trove Cove. Because that's where you did it there. But I'm gonna fucking end it here, because this has already been going for like 1.5 million years. I wanted to finish level 1. But we'll finish level 1 next time. I'll get the cheat codes. Everybody will get everything. It'll be great. I'll fucking fly up here and get this thing from this snake, because, I mean, I still can't get it because I can't even get up here, but, oh, wait a minute, wait, no, I can't get this, but I do have raised, no, wait a minute, is that a blank side over there? Holy shit, folks, oh, and there's a cheat code? All right, hang on, we're getting two more things. Somehow I didn't notice this the entire time, but guess what, would have mattered anyway, wasn't using Ray's controller yet. Now, with the power of Ray's silver controller, I'm getting cocky, let's try and get this fucking jigsaw piece. Oh, what a finisher. Oh, I fucked it up, I got cocky. It's okay. At least I don't have to leave the fucking room and come back, and he's looking right at me, but he didn't care, so he fell asleep again. Okay, now you're making me look bad. Oh, I dropped two. Shit. This is gonna be tense. Okay, just line up the shot, line it up. Camera, please. God. It's insane how little you have to fucking tilt the analog stick. Oh, it's so scary. God damn it! You fucking fucker. Fuck! Oh my god! Holy shit! I don't remember all this shit! This is driving me fucking nuts! Dude, Banjo, what are you doing, man? You're running in there like, oh my god. It's the stopping that fucks you, because then you gotta push it forward again, and then you go too far. Don't fucking stop, dickhead. Get the fuck out of here. Holy fucking shit. Jesus. And I like how the snake doesn't even come out to see what went on. Like, once you grab it, he just knows you have it and doesn't care. So this is what I'm talking about. Watch, this guy's gonna try and get me. Get ready. Yeah. There you go. You gotta get ready for him. You wait for them. They wait for you. Something. All right. Woo! So how many? Okay, so that's, see, I want to fucking finish it because that's seven jiggies. There's only two more in this world, and one of them is from all the Jinjos, and I think the other one is probably from opening that prison with the password. But fuck it. I'll figure that shit out next time. Let's end part one in under 2 hours, and hopefully people will come back for part two, but they probably won't, because who the hell would watch this? Ikum bokum, ikum.